really need to do all those diagnostic tests. It's too expensive. It's wasting money. So there were inroads made by the third-party payers, particularly managed care, and there were also changes, there was the reaction or the pushback against medical paternalism that's most clearly reflected in the emergence of the informed consent requirement in the late 1960s. Doctors now had to share the decision making with their patients, and this led also to a disenchantment with mainstream medicine and the sort of reemergence or growth of alternative ways of providing medical care, what we call complementary and alternative practitioners, chiropractic, osteopathy, but also biofeedback, acupuncture, the kinds of alternative ways of practicing medicine. Those which had been very powerful in the 19th century began to reassert themselves, and by about 1985, patients made more visits to so-called alternative practitioners. There were a greater number of office visits to alternative practitioners than to the so-called mainstream, you know, orthodox physicians. Another thing that happened was that the medical profession began to lose its power over the standard of care. The locality rule was abandoned in almost all states, and the judicial deference to the standard of custom began to disappear. 11 states and the District of Columbia abandoned the custom standard expressly in favor of a reasonableness standard, and 9 other states have done so implicitly simply by stating the standard of care is that of a